Ohio State and that team up north. It's the biggest rivalry in college football, and some would say in all of sports. I sat down with Ohio State historian Jack Park to talk about a few of the Ohio State anniversaries being celebrated this year and the impact that the game has on the players and the coaches.
Recently, Ohio State has dominated the series, but in the 116 years of the rivalry, that hasn't always been the case. In fact, this year only marks the 100th year since our first victory.
16th game of the series, Ohio State, of course, had won none of the first 15, so that was quite an achievement for Ohio State to finally beat Michigan, and it was, of course, because of the play of the immortal Chick Harley that Ohio State was finally able to defeat Michigan.
Final score, 13-30. You know, Ohio State had been so bad leading up to that win that the rivalry almost ended.
I think Ohio State always wanted to play Michigan, but I think there was some fear on Ohio State's part that Michigan would no longer schedule Ohio State because they were such an easy victory, really.
It's hard to believe considering OSU has only lost two games since 2000. That's thanks to the domination of Jim Tressel and Urban Meyer. And there's another coach who dominated this rivalry, Woody Hayes.
When Woody came in 1951, he actually lost two of his first three games. In fact, they were both shutouts. And those were kind of cold winters for him, I think, following that. But beginning in 1954, Ohio State would really start to dominate the series.
It was in that 1954 meeting that Jack Gibbs, a walk-on, changed the course of the game.
And he approached Woody Hayes and said, I just want to play. And Woody said, if you're willing to do the work, we'll give you an opportunity. But he worked very, very hard. And his senior year, which was 1954, he worked himself up to be a second team linebacker. Late in the second quarter of that 1954 game, the Buckeyes were down 7-0.
Thanks to an injury, Gibbs went in.
And on the next play, he intercepted a Michigan pass thrown by Jim Maddock and returned that pass all the way to the Michigan 10-yard line.
That play shifted the momentum of the game, leading the Buckeyes to a victory over Michigan and eventually a national title.
And I think if you look back at Woody Hayes' 28 years as head coach and had to pick one play that's really significant, it might be that interception by Jack Gibbs.
In his first 18 years as head coach, Woody Hayes went 12-6 against that team up north. Then exactly 50 years ago, Bo Schembechler took charge and broke the Buckeyes' 22-game winning streak, an anniversary we would like to forget.
Probably the most significant game in the history of the Big Ten Conference, and certainly one of the great upsets ever in college football history. And that started what we commonly know now as the 10-year war.
A war that would only end after Woody's time as a coach ended, which leads us to another upset, this time for the good guys and Earl Bruce's last game as the Buckeyes head coach.
Michigan had a much better team that year. They really did. That was not one of Ohio State's really good teams. And the way Ohio State released him, the word got out on the Monday before the Michigan game. And those players couldn't believe it.
At one point, the Buckeyes were down 13-0, but came back to win it all 20-23.
I think if Earl was with us here today, he might say that's his favorite Ohio State victory because of the way those players rallied around him and sent him out as a winner.
Those are just a few moments in time for a rivalry that has stretched on for over a century and shows no signs of slowing down. Go Bucks!